What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another dope episode of Loquacious. They call me Nelly.
And it's your girl, Moody.
And I'm Smooth.
It's your boy, Moutouvel. What up?
So jumping right into today's chit-chat, we're going to start off with bullying. We're talking workplace bullying and school bullying. Who want to take us off?
I'll take y'all off.
What's up?
I think it's very sad when it comes from adults. Bullying can sometimes be like, you know, not wanting to help nobody, or the newcomers and hazing them or making them do beyond and above, or not just being that helping hand that they need, especially when you first start. I think it's sad because you will want, you know, somebody to help you, and you would think you'd be mature enough to act appropriate at a job setting. And that's how you know when you have these kids in school where they came from, the stupid parents that's bullying at work, they kids be bullying at school. And let me tell you one thing, I'm teaching my kids, don't let no bully bully you at all. And you at work, talk, I don't care if you brand new, talk up for yourself, because you're too old one to be letting anybody intimidate you. Kids, you know, they don't know themselves. But at the end of the day, it's up to us to put in them. Don't stand for those type of atmospheres or whatever. But at work, nah. Put your foot down right at the gate. What you think, Mooch?
What up, ladies? How y'all doing today? Hey. Yeah, live from 34th Street right now. New York is back open.
Yeah.
New York is back open. We back open. But yeah, I experienced the bullying. I witnessed it. I've been bullied. They tried, you know, but you know, I'm from Fort Rock, America, so it ain't happening like that. You feel me? There's times I watch, I even work with people that I came in the game with. You get what I'm saying? They got higher up and then they started abusing their powers, acting like they don't know where they came from. You feel me? I don't like that, man. It's sad. And then there's a lot of little kids, young kids that don't know no better to nothing. So they get abused every day. I work retail. If y'all didn't know, you feel me? Retail. So in retail, you see it a lot. No, all jokes aside, though, in retail, you see it a lot. You know, these little managers, they get supervisor positions. They get XYZ positions.
Yeah.
And then they want to treat us like we peasants. It's horrible. You know, shit they wouldn't do. Like, oh, man, it's just, I want Smooth to talk, and I'm going to get right back on this because I'm getting emotional right now. I'm getting emotional.
So I definitely don't agree with bullying. I hate it. Like, I don't see what's the point of it. And I was always taught that a bully is someone who's insecure with
themselves. Insecure, yes.
Yeah.
So whenever I ever faced a bully, I just remind myself of that. Like, it's something about you that you don't like. I love me. So you can't break my spirit. And I also teach my children. They already know I don't tolerate bullying. I was that person in school that was beating up the bullies. Every time Javon was in a fight, Smooth was in a fight, it was because she was beating up a bully. I cannot stand bullies.
Well,
wait on. Let me.
Go ahead.
You know, the bullying shit is dangerous first and foremost, because nowadays you bully a lot of people and they take it to heart. You know, you push them around. And it was a time where I worked with a guy named David. I'm going to say his name, David. He was working. He was out there bullying this guy. He was fresh from North Carolina, a little nerd, youngin', just treating him, calling him names, making him do extra stuff. It was horrible. And that nerd guy from North Carolina, enough was enough, and he went off. He went off, and he had it. Listen.
Yeah.
That's why a lot of stuff be happening at work. That's why people come back to the jobs nowadays for the bullying. They always come back for the bullying.
They call that going postal. I feel like this, at school, as far as the bullying go at school, I'm totally 100% against it. A lot of children are committing suicide because they're being bullied. And it goes even further than junior high school and high school, it even going to the colleges, because some professors are bullies to the students. And then it go even higher because now you're at your job and you're being bullied. Me personally, at my own job, I see my management get bullied. They're not even the bullies. They're being bullied. And it makes me laugh sometimes because I'm like, damn, I didn't think that this could even be a thing, but it's a thing. And like Mooch said, somebody tried it, but I know I checked it and I haven't had a problem since. So It's safe to say that it takes a strong spirited, thick skinned person to deal with bullying, but some people are not like that. And the people that are not like that, you can't take it lightly because they will come and go postal. And then everybody's trying to figure out, well, why did she come and shoot up the whole entire staff? Yeah. Where was the whole entire staff when she was being bullied? Laughing, thinking it was a game. So that's how school shootings happen. We witnessed a student that we went to school with, guys, we're not going to say their name, but remember when we were in high school, he shot somebody?
Yeah.
Or he got shot or something like that?
Nice. Like, he shot somebody. I remember somebody.
That. So it's just, it's a real thing. Bullying for me is zero tolerance for it. I don't like it in my house. There could be bullying in your relationship. There could be bullying in your family. There could be bullying in school and there could be bullying at work. Bullying never flies. Because never. A person that can't handle it will take matters into their own hand.
I'm saying treat people the way you want to be treated at the end of the day.
Absolutely.
That's bottom line. Respect people. Personal space, respect people as human beings, and we maybe can get somewhere in life.
That's a fact. I totally agree with that.
Crazy.
That's a fact, 100%. I leave them quiet people alone. Listen, I'm the best supervisor you can have. They love me because I don't want to abuse my power.
Any indeed managers looking. Hire him because he's looking for a job, obviously.
Jabal. He gave you his real name on the application.
So we gonna jump into today's topic, speaking of bullies, because you got bullies and then you got friends and then you got frenemies. So our topic today is friends and associates. How do you differentiate the two? So Smooth gonna take us off. What's a friend?
A friend to me is someone I can count on. At any given moment, my weakest moments, my strongest moments, when I'm happy, when I'm sad, someone who is not going to stab me in my back when I'm not looking. Someone I put in years with. I put in years with my friends. My friends, I have invested years. They know my deepest secrets. I know theirs. When we get into fights and arguments, it's never going to come out. I'm going to take it to the grave. That's a friend of me. An associate, that's somebody that I casually know, I hang out with here and there. We talk, we chill, but I still don't trust you 1,000%. You like, right there.
So, what up, Mooch?
Man, listen. Me and Vinny Gorgeous, a.k.a. Hood, a.k.a. Carl Goodlow. My
Yo,
brother
stop
from
saying niggas governments.
It don't even matter. Listen. Me and him, we got 36 years in the game. That's my bro. Like, we graduated from the friendship to brothers. We brothers. You feel me? That's a friend right there. That's a friend. If I'm down and out, he'll call. Whatever the case may be, he going to make sure I'm Gucci. He going to tell me when I'm right, like you. He going to tell me when I'm wrong. He ain't no yes man. A real friend going to tell you if your pussy stinks. I'm sorry, y'all.
I don't even want to be that close to you to know that, though.
Yeah. I mean, I mean, you might be between her legs and getting your head done, and you'd be like, oh.
We don't do that no more. We too old to be sitting down between somebody's legs.
Yeah.
What's good, Moody?
What's going on, y'all? Y'all, my friendships, you know, I'm kind of very particular who I put in my circle, who I leave in my circle. Nelly been my friend since grade school, literally the first, second grade school. So Nelly is a friend. Somebody you spend invested time, 100% has respect. Now, like Smooth said, fight and argue. I don't fight and argue with my friends. We can disagree to we can agree to disagree, but we not fighting. We not doing none of that.
Hold on, Moody.
If I feel like you giving me that outside kind of energy, that's going to take my equilibrium off. Like, it's going to make me think you
have
like,
a chemical imbalance. Okay.
Right. I'm just not going to understand because now I feel like the respect balance ain't there. And once you lose respect for me, there's no way I can trust you. Because I could say, today the sky is purple and you want to say it's blue. And now you stabbing me in my back. I just don't trust people like that no more. Like, at the end of the day, like, friendship, you got to have respect, loyalty on all types of angles. Like, we could disagree. I ain't got no problems. You cannot even talk to me. I don't got no problems with that. But when I feel like you don't got no respect, then that's a problem. So that's how I determine which is associate and which one is my friend. Nelly, what you think?
So as far as I'm concerned, Moody, Smooth, the world knows Muchavel is my brother. But Moody and I definitely have since the sandbox. Smooth and I since high school. So we were 14 and me and Moody was like 6. So however you slice it, these two women and my girl Digga are my best friends in the whole wide world. Now, they know me. They know that I get mad and I block them. They know that I could not talk to them for a few days. But at the end of the day, they don't never have to question whether I'm not going to be their friend anymore or whether I'm stabbing them in the back or whether I'm doing anything that's sus. As Moody stated, respect goes a long way. I'm able to tell them stuff, and as long as we're able to come back from it, I can tell you, yo, you get on my nerves. I don't like when you say stuff like that. And I can say that and still be their friend. I could tell them, nah, that outfit looks dumb, and still be friends. It's not like, it's not a battle between us of trying to figure out who's right and who's wrong. No, if I'm right, I'm told that I'm wrong. If I'm right, I'm right. And if I'm wrong, they tell me I'm wrong, and I still want to be their friend. Javon, the most Smooth, I curse out the most probably. And then she don't talk to me for some days. And then I just call her like, yo, hey, what's up? Like, what you doing? Good morning. And then it'll be right back to normal. But
I ain't even gonna lie. 2 days ago, you pissed me off and I don't appreciate you commenting on my post and you knew I was mad at you.
Yeah, so she subs me on social media, guys. She's been doing that for years, right, Moody?
Yeah.
And I respond to the text because I'm like, but you know, for me, my friend is somebody who I don't have to see every day. I don't have to talk to. That's not what I do, but that's what it is for me. Like Digga, I don't talk to Digga every day. I don't see her every day. But at the end of the day, Rochelle know I love her. And I'm going to die for her, and I'm coming out swinging for her. So it goes like that. Like, I have associates. None of my work people are my, like, they're not my friends. They're my cool-ass coworkers. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't like when people, like, start to mix and mingle. Like, these are my friends. No. You're not my friend. And there's no shade and there's no pun intended. Well, y'all are my cool-ass coworkers.
All right, so let me ask you a question. So nobody that you call your co-worker, you ain't jacking, they just co-workers. Y'all got something to do after work, XYZ. So none of them is your
friend. There is a handful of them that are closer to me than the rest.
No. Mm-hmm. I've been fortunate to have jobs in my life where I had co-workers that became like family to me. You know, God rest in peace, my sister, Bunky, Javon, I miss you. That was my sister. Like, you couldn't tell me no different. Like, you know, she was there for me from day one. Like, we clicked from day one. I have people that I grew up with in church that is like, I would like, hands down, like, what'd you say? What happened? I'm there. And vice versa. If I need them, they're there for me. So I can't say people not at my job or my, like, other places, but it's very slim to none.
Yeah. So let me tell you some qualities. Hold on, guys. Let me tell you some qualities of a true friend. They love you for yourself. They give more than they take. They compromise. They forgive you even without an apology. They believe in you. They make time for you. They are respectful to you, as Moody said. They'll always be honest with you. These are friends that aren't afraid to give you a wake-up call whenever necessary. That's so important before anybody jump in. That's very important that you're able to have that type of relationship where you could tell somebody something and they don't take offense to it. Because if this is my friend, or if I consider you my friend and you tell me something, it's not to be offensive. It's not with malice. It's because I'm your friend. Why wouldn't I tell you?
Even if you take offense to it. You can take offense to it, but friendship will be able to break it down where you can feel comfortable with the uncomfortable thing that we spoke about. Because we, in our previous episodes, those are a part of those uncomfortable conversations you might have with your friend.
So before we cross-examine, let me give some shout-outs to some people. I posted on the Facebook what they considered a friend, and we got some feedback. So this is from at Mark. He said, the thing that makes you a friend, you actually care about the people who are close to you, right? We have one from at Linda Quintine. She said, being able to come back from a breakup and still have a strong bonding relationship is a true friend. Amen. So we got at Janine Henderson. She said, your mom and I ride and die for each other. She is more of a sister to me. I love her as if she was my blood. That's a friend. We do it for each other. I love her. Then we have at StatQuo, a good friend is loyal, encouraging, and accept you. Along with that, our relationship has to stand the test of time. I can't call a person my friend because we've been hanging tough for a few months. I can consider you a cool person, but I'd be reluctant to call you a friend. And we also got from at Doc, a friend is someone who pushes you to the apex and also pulls you from the bottom. A friend is a 24/7, 365 days a year job, which entails being a doctor, nurse, lawyer, best bondsman, butler, maid, chef, Uber driver, AAA, babysitter, event planner, loan shark, financial advisor, secret keeper, psychiatrist, vandalism partner, bartender, stylist, hairdresser, co-signer, liar, and photographer. So just quickly, at Doc, we're going to shout you out. At StatQuo, shouting you out. At Linda Quintana, shouting you out. At Janine Henderson, shouting you out. And at Mark, we shouting you out. Thank you guys so much for responding. So we want to cross-examine
Macy's.
Now.
Macy's is a good friend to me too, because they keep me looking good for the ladies out there. Even though I'm in a relationship, Macy's is my good friend.
Right, because it sounds like you're selling yourself.
And look. No, hell no. And then Mills is my barber from Best Style. He's my friend.
Mills, from me to you, bro, if he lift up that hat right now.
My man Money Mills from Best Style, man. Green. He keep me looking good. That's why they be on my body. But I'm
so
ladies,
do you guys think that you have to is a certain amount of time to consider a person a friend?
No, because that's just like a relationship. It's just like saying, oh, you need 15 years to be and married to this person. No, you can find love.
See, I think
in
it's
the
a
first
little
48.
Different when it comes to the friendship thing for me.
Nah, not me.
I'm not meeting you tomorrow and you my best friend next month. Or my
friend next month.
You will be a good associate, but you, for me, you got to put in years. I need to know that I can trust you with my secrets. I need to know when. I'm a Libra, so if anybody knows dealing with a Libra.
You'll be with somebody from day one, and them niggas still envy you.
There are situations that happen like that, but I like to think that I chose my friends wisely enough that I don't ever have to come into that. I have
you
five friends.
You don't know
friends.
What Nelly said about you yesterday. No, I'm joking.
I have five. Oh, and just an FYI to everybody out there, I pop mad shit about my friends, and that's why I'm their friend, because I be like, yo,
Nelly,
she get on my fucking nerves. Like, why would she do that stupid shit? Like, I can't fucking stand her dumbass. And then I call her and be like, yo, what you doing? Like, you still want to go to the park? Like, you taking all fucking day to get dressed? So I do I'd that.
Like, nah, don't act like you wasn't mad. Now you get on my nerve. Yeah, what we eating?
Yup. I curse my friends out and I always pop shit because I be tight. Like, yo, she's mad annoying. She said to come and get her. It's fucking 5:30 and now I gotta wait till 6:30. Like, damn, she mad slow. I'm that friend.
No, you're 5:30 to 5:35 friend, honking like 100 times.
Come outside. I said I was coming. I live around the corner.
Nah,
come outside.
I kind of get close with people, you know?
I do too.
I get close with people, but it's just something that rubs me the wrong way when people are just like nasty or just have an attitude or negative or just feel like,
yeah, I don't like those energies.
I don't like the negativity, which is why I said for me, it's going to take time to see if we could be friends, because you're going to have to go through me having an attitude, me being broke, me being hungry, to see how you're going to deal with me in that moment to know if you're a friend or not. Because my friend is going to be like, all right, you hungry? Let's go get something to eat. All right, you broke it. It'll be plenty of times when I'm on the phone with Chanel and we're just cash-apping each other money back and forth for no apparent reason. Like, one time I seen a grill online and I'm like, oh, I like this grill. I want some grill steak. And the next day is a grill at my door. Like, I need to know that you're going to put that time and that work in.
All right. This ain't y'all rich. Y'all rich. Cash at me $5.
You a bum. Cash app don't work.
Yes. That's a bum, yo. Damn.
Yeah. Give me $5.
So in retrospect, friendship is about trusting. It's very similar to a relationship. And you know what's so funny? I've read that breakups in friendships is worse than breakups in relationships.
But it's only with women. It's only with women. Because the only time niggas stop fucking with their homies is when they ratted or did some bullshit. But when it comes to y'all women,
y'all hate just as much as women do too. Yes, y'all do.
Now, women take it a little bit more personal. Women,
they do, but the men do it the same.
But when men don't fight like women, can you be friends? Can you be a friend that you disfriended?
It depends on what the person did. Like, because I could not be your friend because we just stopped speaking, right? For whatever the reason, but it was no disrespect. We just stopped speaking. Now, if it's disrespect and we ain't being friends.
So is it what's the levels of disrespect? Like a physical altercation?
You talk about my kid?
No.
We ain't never being friends. We never.
Nah. I'm not jacking that. Because
you fight your friends. Me and Hood
and B-Mone and other guys had a million and one fights. And we was
my brother. That's guys, though. I'm not fighting.
If you put your hands on me, I'm going to want to stab you. So don't, we never going to be friends.
Yeah, I don't want to fight either.
Sorry. See, that's the difference between
men and women. I agree with you.
And y'all.
Women take it way more personal. Y'all niggas get drunk. I have
one best friend, Sherelle. We fought like cats and dogs growing up. We definitely did.
But you guys were friends since y'all was like elementary school.
We've been friends since we were in elementary school. And
so that's kind of
so
different
much that
as
our
an adult.
Parents, as an adult, not happening.
Yeah, I'm not being
from elementary to now. Anybody that was my friend that tried to fight me, we're no longer friends.
No, I'm friends with people that I had.
That's why, and that's why.
Am I lying?
That's why we are men is different than women.
Except for one person. Shout out to my girl Ash. We've been friends since I can't even remember.
Y'all had a fight, Moody?
Who won, Moody? Who won?
That's
don't lie.
Right now.
No. Oh, you took the L. It sounded like you took the L. Who won?
Moody.
What happened?
She won.
Moody, I know you got them hands. Moody.
She's my friend.
You could tell it. You can tell the truth though. This is WeTellingTheTruth.com. You can tell the truth. She ain't gonna hurt her. It's facts that happened in the past.
Ain't gonna hurt her, but now I'm not putting my friend on blast. That's why you don't put your friends on blast.
This is a whole podcast. We're gonna talk about the facts. We're gonna talk about the facts, baby girl.
I mean, we friends, you know, and that's one of my friends I don't speak to every day.
You about to cook, Moody?
It was on my table.
What is that? Seafood. Yeah, that's seafood. She got crab legs.
She got that EBT. You must have let her borrow your EBT card.
Yeah, no,
I gotta give it back, Moot. I gotta give it back. Yeah,
definitely. I said you only could take 30. You took, like you took 300.
My dad was only 40, man.
God wait, damn. So you're not coming back from friendships.
Not if we fight. If you talk about my kids or you do anything to my kids, we never coming back. Now if we disagree, we get a heated argument. It's a possibility. As long as you understand, don't cross those boundaries. And as well as me, don't cross those boundaries.
Nah, you know I mean,
we
got to
figure out what's the issue. But
because you can always agree to disagree. There's nothing wrong with
friend,
that.
I want to believe that you was my friend. And especially if you ain't talking about me behind my back and doing all that extra stuff, then yeah, we could be friends again. You know, I might not play you as close as I used to. It might take some time to rebuild that friendship, that friendly love that you have, but if you trying to fight or do any of those, nah, we done.
At this age, though, say that at that age, but
at this age, yeah, at this age, yeah, I don't because got no
we're all consenting adults. We're all over 30 with children, yeah, with families.
That's how I feel too. Like
I don't really. I'm not in the market for new friends. I just go along with the flow of things. Like Smooth said, like I like to keep my energy protected. And I know a lot of people don't mean well. They come into your life to like kind of like stir shit up and bring the dramas from their life into yours.
That's only y'all women.
Because I know it's both. Because me and my husband have a conversation all the time. And it depends on what a person has been raised like and who they be around. Because sometimes people associate dysfunction with friendships and lovers. So they have these toxic relationships and they think they bomb, but they toxic. But they only are okay with it because that's what they used to.
And it's horrible.
So you botching me in my hair every day, Moochie, and me and you together, the next person I get with, I might think that, you know, it's okay for him to bust me in my head because he love me. No.
No, I ain't going to lie. I got coworkers from three different jobs that I fuck with more than niggas that I grew up with because they real right niggas. Like it ain't no time limit. That's what I'm trying to let y'all know. It ain't no time limit on a friendship. Real recognize real when it comes to the guys. I don't know about y'all ladies, but real recognize real. And these niggas made sure I was with motherfucking niggas that made sure I got home safe. Tucked in the bed type shit. It's a lot of real friends that I see.
It be your own blood, Moochie. Don't worry about it.
It'll be your own blood that'll let you fend for yourself. And then it'll be niggas that you probably met like 3 months ago that'll make sure you got home safe, pay for your cab, put you to the building door. That it happened. It's real life shit. It happened to me.
I done have friends allow me to stay with them for years and then you got, without a bother, without anything. And, you know, you people like that, you keep close to your heart. And no matter what they going through or whatever, you try to be there as much as you can for them.
That's right.
That's how I see it.
I'm glad that you guys are my friends. I love you.
Yes, I love you guys.
Well, this has been another
my friend too since high school. We're not as close as Nelly,
but we're getting way better. We're getting so much better. I appreciate you coming all the way to Pennsylvania for my birthday. I love my birthday mug, my birthday slippers. I love you, some smooth.
Yes, I do.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, have a blessed weekend. This has been another lit episode of Loquacious. They call me Nelly.
And it's your girl Moody.
And I'm Smooth.
And this is Loquacious. And we hope
and
that Mucha you have
Bell a- got kicked off from service.
See yeah, Mucha Bell. He lost service, but y'all know the vibes. Fridays at 5, catch us. We got some flyers. If you see them on your car, do not use them as no goddamn dustpan. Church if you see fan. This on your car, make sure you follow the prompt. You go on YouTube, you type in LOQUACIOUSTV, you subscribe, you watch, you like, you share, okay? We love
Please, you. Share. We love y'all for real. Bye.